What a beautiful sight. Seeing everything torn apart like this and cleaned up. Not as bad as what I thought it was. A lot of icky parts, of course. And I better mark these left and right before I forget. But anyway, almost... No, I shouldn't say almost, but very similar to Virago parts that I pulled apart before, so I'm not going to get into the gory details, but everything seems to be in pretty good shape. There wasn't really too much, just a little bit of corrosion on that ring, and you'll see it. I think you might be able to see it in there, not sure. Yeah, there's a little bit of corrosion inside the tube, and that's because of the ring. I'll get those replaced as well as the seals. The only thing I'm replacing is that stuff right there. So, yeah, everything else looks like it's in pretty good shape. There's really no need for me to go overboard, but I will peel all that clear coat off because it looks like crap. It's just a half-assed job the Yamaha does, but that's all right. That's what I'm here for. I'll get these things all sparkled up, and then we'll put a coating of... matte clear over them, and then once that all sets up, I will put these things back together and get them back on the bike. So I was having a pretty bad night tonight putting these things together. The biggest problem is the torquing of the bolt that goes inside there. If you guys know anything about taking forks apart, servicing forks, changing the seals, there's a bolt, I think, pretty much in all of these old vintage front forks. Virago is no different. The one in here is quite a bit bigger, calls for 60 foot-pounds of torque. And I was really struggling with the homemade tool that I had made, thinking that I could get away with it. I got pretty frustrated. So I just wanted to sort of finish these up. It's the same process as the Virago. These are just a little bit bigger. The drawing in the service manual shows a spacer in here, and of course there isn't, so there's a mistake that caused me to run around freaking out because I thought I had parts missing. I looked here and noticed that there was a setting for this as well, which is 5 is normal. I'll start there. So they're both set up, both with new O-rings at the top, new oils, new seals, cleaned up and ready to go back in the bike. And let's do that. We'll sort of get these things out of the way. And all it's really going to be is to get them on the motorcycle just so I can, it's a place to store them basically more than anything. Once these are installed, I use the sort of the weight of them to gauge the torque on the bearings for the steering head. So I think the initial torque is, I think 52, and then you back it off and then you tighten up until it's just, till you get a good feel for it. And then the big nut on the top is 80 foot-pounds. So it's quite a bit on that top nut. But the initial setup, I'll do that as well. I'll review it in the service manual, make sure the manual isn't wrong. But for now, let's get these forks back in the bike. I'm just gonna snug these up for now. I'll torque them later. This is basically just to get them locked in so they don't go anywhere.
All right. Well, as much as it may look or appear to be a real oddball thing to do, that's the normal procedure for tightening down these type of bearings, these taper bearings. So basically what it is, what you're doing is after you've set those bearings in place and you've taken off any play, that little bit of tightening that you're doing, all you're doing is just, you know, snugging it up at this point in time. It's a little more than a snug, but all the play is out and there's no binding at all. I'll grab the forks as well in a minute and give them a good pull left to right, side to side, and up and down as well. Of course, they shouldn't move. And then the next part is to put the lock washers and everything else back on. So let's do that. This is the nut that's going to get a lot of torque here in a minute. I think that's 80. I'll have to review it in the manual, but that's going to be quite a bit here, and we'll get that torqued up as well. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with the handlebars, or the clip-ons, I should say. So I'm probably just snug these down, but I will torque this because I don't want to be dealing with the steering after this point. So snug these in. I'll snug these in, the top ones, and then we'll torque that bolt. All right, it's 110 newton meters, which is 82 foot-pounds of torque. Hopefully I can do this by myself without assistance. Wow, that feels good. So much different than before. Okay, well, that just about wraps up the steering stuff. Except for, of course, like I said, the clip-ons and stuff. I've got to do a lot of work with the electrical stuff and the grips and all that and the throttle. So I'll leave these guys as they are. I'll leave the rest of these. I haven't torqued these bolts yet. I've got quite a bit of work to do in the front end here, as you can see. but the top and the steering and the bearings, I wanted to sort of get them all wrapped up. And everything looks really good. Yeah, so that lock ring is in there just right. Everything is in the right order. I had to buy a couple of parts for the whole assembly, and of course the bearings are all new. All I did was just paint this, and it turned out really nice. So I painted this, and then of course I put in the vise, and then I sanded this, sanded the paint off to get that brush look, and then I cleared the whole thing. So looks back to OEM. Forks are all done, set up as per spec, I guess. These preload adjusters set to 5. Still need a little bit of cleaning up, but they look okay. I'm just going to double check whether or not this is the proper way to do it, but it's the only way I would imagine that you can get these caps out to service the oil or do anything else that you need to do. All right, man, this whole thing looks great. The feeling and the satisfaction of knowing that it's done properly. And, you know, being a mechanic obviously would help, but, you know, you don't have to have a license to do this stuff. But holy cow, can you ever save a lot of money? Can you imagine? I mean, this is probably $300 or $400 to replace the bearings properly. And I don't know how much it would have been to service those forks. Certainly not to restore them, but just to get new seals in them. Probably at least 4 or 5, maybe even 6 hours. But that's it. It's all buttoned up. Steering's all sorted out, and I know I don't have to go back and touch this. Just another thing to knock off my list. And now with that, it's time to move on with something else.